Ever have one of those puzzles where no matter how you rotate the piece, it just doesn't fit? That's how astronomers felt for a long time about Mercury's orbit. After Newton's law of universal gravitation was established, scientists could predict planetary orbits with incredible accuracy. But Mercury didn't follow the rules. Its orbit was off. As Mercury traveled around the Sun, its elliptical orbit shifted over time, creating a wobble in its path. Newton's laws could predict most of this shift, but not all of it. The math was off by a tiny amount, but in science, even small inconsistencies matter. For decades, astronomers searched for answers. Some thought an unseen planet near the Sun was pulling on Mercury. Others blamed flawed observations or mathematical errors. But the unseen planet never appeared, and tweaking Newton's equations didn't solve the puzzle. Then in 1915, Albert Einstein presented a revolutionary idea. His solution? To rethink gravity itself. I mean, when you're Einstein, rewriting the rules of the universe is just another Tuesday. Instead of modifying Newton's framework, Einstein built upon it, and in the process gave us an entirely new way to understand the cosmos. But wait, if Einstein's theory redefines gravity, why do we still study Newton's law today? Could it be that Newton's framework still holds value in certain situations? In this lesson, we'll explore how Einstein's view of gravity compares to Newton's and uncover the groundbreaking implications of Einstein's discoveries. Let's start by building a timeline of how our understanding of gravity has evolved. Kepler described how planets move with his three laws, but he didn't know why planets follow these paths. Then Newton connected Kepler's observations to a universal force, gravity. Newton saw gravity as a force, an invisible rope pulling objects together. His laws explained planetary motion and tides. But Newton never explained what caused gravity. Why do objects pull on each other? That's where Einstein stepped in. He proposed something radical. Gravity isn't a force at all. Instead, it's the result of massive objects bending the fabric of space and time, what we call space-time. In Einstein's view, planets orbit the Sun not because they're pulled by a force, but because they follow the curved paths created by the Sun's mass. This idea forms the basis of Einstein's theory of relativity. So, which version of gravity do astronomers use? Newton's or Einstein's? Well, both, actually. Newton's laws are great for everyday situations, like calculating satellite orbits or predicting tides. But Einstein's theory explains gravity in extreme cases, like near black holes, massive stars, or at high speeds. Let's take a closer look at Einstein's theory and see how it explains Mercury's puzzling orbit. To understand Mercury's orbit, we need to understand Einstein's theory of relativity in more detail. Let's break it down into two key ideas, the equivalence principle and the warping of space-time. To understand the equivalence principle, imagine you're standing in an elevator and suddenly it starts accelerating upward. You feel heavier, almost as if you put on a weighted vest. It feels like gravity has increased. Now imagine instead that you're on a spaceship in deep space, far from any planets or stars. If the ship accelerates forward, you'd feel pushed back into your seat, just like gravity was pulling you down. According to Einstein, these two experiences, acceleration and gravity, are indistinguishable. This idea is called the equivalence principle, and it's a cornerstone of Einstein's theory. In simpler terms, Einstein realized that gravity isn't a force pulling objects. It's the effect of objects following curved paths in space-time. Which brings us to the second key idea, the warping of space-time. Einstein showed space and time are connected, forming a four-dimensional fabric we call space-time. To picture this, start with the three dimensions you're familiar with, length, width, and height. Now imagine adding a fourth dimension, time. Together, these create space-time. Massive objects, like the sun, create dents or warps in this fabric. Smaller objects, like planets, follow these curves. Imagine you rolled a marble across a perfectly flat trampoline. How do you think it would move? It'd move in a straight line. Now imagine placing a bowling ball on the trampoline. How would that change the marble's path? Pause the video and make a prediction. The ball creates a dip in the surface, and if you roll a smaller ball, like a marble, near the dip, the marble spirals around the bowling ball. It doesn't move in a straight line because the curved surface guides its path. The closer you are to the massive body creating the dent, the more space-time is warped. Why is this fact important when thinking about the orbit of Mercury? Mercury is the closest planet to the Sun. Newton's laws worked well for most planets because their orbits aren't close enough to the Sun to feel these extreme effects. But Mercury? It orbits much closer to the Sun than any other planet, so the warping of space-time becomes significant. As Mercury travels along this highly curved region of space-time, its orbit shifts slightly more than Newton's equations can account for. Einstein's equations, however, include this warping effect. When scientists apply them to Mercury's orbit, the math lined up perfectly. Einstein's theory solved the puzzle. Now that we've seen how Einstein's theory solved the mystery of Mercury's orbit, let's explore the implications of this theory on other aspects of the cosmos. Einstein's theory of relativity didn't just solve the puzzle of Mercury's orbit. It opened the door to profound discoveries about our universe. His equations predicted phenomena that seemed almost unbelievable at the time, but were later confirmed through observation and experimentation. Let's briefly explore these predictions in the order they unfolded. A key test of Einstein's theory came in 1919 during a solar eclipse. Based on Einstein's theory, light should be bent as it passes near a massive object like the Sun, following the curves of space-time. But under normal conditions, the Sun's light is so bright that it hides the stars near its edge, making this effect impossible to observe. The solar eclipse provided a rare opportunity. For a few minutes, the Moon blocked the Sun's light, revealing the stars behind it. Scientists observed that the light from distant stars was bent as it passed near the Sun, a phenomenon Einstein predicted in his equations. This effect, called gravitational lensing, occurs because massive objects like stars or galaxies warp space-time, bending the path of light. This historic observation provided the first direct evidence for Einstein's theory of relativity. Today, we use gravitational lensing to study dark matter, discover distant galaxies, and even identify exoplanets. Another early prediction of relativity is time dilation, the idea that time doesn't tick at the same rate everywhere. Einstein showed that time slows down near massive objects, or for objects moving at high speeds. This concept was later confirmed through experiments using atomic clocks placed at different altitudes or moving at high speeds. It's actually crucial for modern technology. GPS satellites orbit Earth in weaker gravity than we experience on the surface, so their clocks tick slightly faster. Without accounting for this effect, GPS systems wouldn't work. Einstein's equations also hinted at the existence of objects so massive and compact that they would warp space-time to the extreme, black holes. For many years, black holes were considered purely theoretical, But over time, evidence mounted, including the discovery of X-rays from matter falling into black holes. We've now even captured the first image of a black hole's shadow, confirming their existence. One of the most recent confirmations of Einstein's predictions came in 2015 with the first detection of gravitational waves. Gravitational waves are ripples in space-time created by massive objects in motion, like two black holes spiraling toward each other. When they collide, they send waves through space-time, much like ripples spreading across a pond. Gravitational waves allow us to detect cosmic events that were previously invisible. These waves carry information about the mass and speed of the objects that created them, opening an entirely new way to explore the universe. You'll explore each of Einstein's predictions in more depth during our lesson activities and other lessons in the course. Today, we learned about Einstein's unique view of gravity as the warping of space-time by massive objects. As we conclude, consider this. Mercury's orbit was just a small clue that led to this groundbreaking shift in our understanding of the cosmos. What other mysteries are out there, waiting for the right puzzle piece to be found? See you next time as we uncover more mysteries of the universe. Hey, hey.